Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, importance of ratio analysis, watch the video till the end. And also if you're new to this channel, then don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button given down at the bell icon that's given below. Thank you everyone for joining the session today. Today we have a topic called importance of ratio analysis, which is basically a financial statement analysis topic. And ratio analysis is one of the most pivotal thing in any analysis or for any analyst to work upon any valuations or probably equity research or making any sort of decision-making scenario, because ratios play a key role. It gives you an overall impact analysis. Let me begin with an introduction. See, the purpose and the importance of the ratio analysis are to evaluate and analyze the what we call as the financial performance or of the firm in terms of the risk, profitability, solvency, and the efficiency. It helps us to compare the so-called the trends. Okay. These trends of two or more companies over the period of time. Now, we shall discuss the importance and the uses of the ratio analysis in a much more detailed way. First, the analysis of the financial statement. Analysis of financial statements is the prior thing. Now, interpretation of the financial statements and the data is essential for any internal, for all the internal and external stakeholders of the firm. With the help of the ratio analysis, we interpret the numbers from the balance sheets, from the income statement. Okay. So every stakeholder has different interest when it comes down to result to the financial, like the equity investors are more interested in the growth of the dividend payments and the earning power of the organization in the long run. So the creditors would like to ensure that they get their so-called repayment on their due on their specific time frame. Well, the ratio analysis has been divided into this particular format. As you can see, there is solvency ratio, which has liquidity and turnover ratio. Then we have the operating performance ratios, like operating efficiency ratios and profitability. These are the types. These are the heads. These are the types. And then we have the subtypes. Risk analysis has business, financial, and external liquidity risk, and growth has the growth rate ratios. Well, second, it helps in understanding the profitability of the company. Now, profitability ratio, it basically helps to determine how the profitable firm is, return on the assets, that is ROA, and return on the equity. It basically helps to understand the ability of the firm to generate earnings. And return on the assets is the total net income divided by the total assets. So it means how many does a company earns a profit for every dollar of its assets. So the return on the equity is the net income by the shareholders' equity. So this ratio basically tells us how well a company uses its investors' money. Ratios like gross profit, net profit margin. So margin here helps to analyze the firm's ability to translate sales into profit. Let me take you to the third ratio, analysis of the operating efficiency ratio or the operating efficiency of the firm. Now, certain ratio helps us to analyze the degree of the efficiency of the firms. Now, ratios like the account receivable turnover ratio, the fixed asset turnover ratios, and the inventory turnover ratio. So these ratios can be compared with the other peers of the same industry and will help us to analyze which firms are better managed as compared to the others. It measures the company's capability to generate income by using these assets, and it looks at various aspects of the firms, like time it generally takes to collect cash from debtors or the time period of the firm to convert the inventory to cash. This is efficiency ratios, which are very important, pivotal, and as an improvement will lead to the growth of the in the profitability. Fourth, the liquidity of the firms. Now, the liquidity basically determines whether the company can pay short-term obligations or not. So by short-term obligations, we mean short-term debts, which can be paid off within the time frame of 12 months, okay, or within the operating cycle. So for an example, the salaries due, sundry creditors, tax payable, outstanding expenses. So what are the kind of the solvency ratio that comes into picture? See, the solvency ratio basically includes the so-called the liquidity ratios. Now, that includes the current ratios, quick ratios, cash ratios, and so on and so forth. And then there is called as the turnover ratios, like receivable turnover ratios, days receivable, inventory turnover, days of inventory turnover, payable turnover, days payable, and cash conversion cycle. Okay, let's understand the fifth point of importance. Now, one of the most important is basically helps in identifying the business risks. Now, one of the most important reasons to use the ratio analysis is that it helps in understanding the business risk of the firm, calculating the leverages like financial leverage, then you have operating leverage. It helps the firms to understand the business risk, that how sensitive the profitability of the company is with respect to its so-called fixed cost deployment. Very important to understand this. And also the current debt outstanding. It basically helps in identifying the so-called the financial risks of the company. Now, another importance of the ratio analysis is that it helps in identifying the financial risks. So ratios like leverage ratio, interest coverage ratio, DSCR ratios, it helps in firms to understand how it is dependent on the external capital, whether they are capable of repaying the debt using the own capital. Seventh, it is used for planning and future forecasting of the firm. Now, analysts and managers can find a trend and use a trend for future forecasting, and can also be used for important decision making by external shareholders or the stakeholders like investors. So they can analyze whether they should invest in a project or not. Eighth, it is basically to compare the performances of the firms. Now, the main use of the ratio analysis is that the strengths and the weakness of each firm can be compared. So the ratios can also be compared to the firm's previous ratio, and it will help to analyze whether the progress has been made by the company or not. So let me give you my final conclusion on this, is that as we have discussed the importance and the uses of the ratio analysis, it is very pivotal and imperative to assess the performances of the firm by analyzing its liquidity, profitability, asset management, and the efficiency ratio. These ratios basically are the analysis point of view are widely used for taking the important decisions and for future forecasting. So you may learn more about ratio analysis from various other, you know, there will be topics that are available on the website like coverage ratios and operating cycle formula and so on and so forth. The list goes on. Go and check it out. That's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's going below. Thank you everyone for joining the session. Cheers everyone.